Hi friends, in today's tutorial we'll be making a collapsible side navigation bar. It's going to look like this. To get started, all you need is an empty Figma file. You can type figma.new in your address bar. It's a nice little shortcut. And there are a couple of things we're going to do to prepare. The first one is we want to load some colors. So you can either add whichever colors you like, or if you would like, you can use my plugin called Variable Starter. So to use that, you're going to select whichever colors you like. I'm just going to select one color, and you can also select radii and spacing. Now, when you go to your variables, you'll find all your colors and other stuff here. One other thing that we want to do is to add some icons. And today I'll be using hero icons to grab my icons from. You can use the Figma file, or you can just search for icons here. Copy the SVG. Rename it and turn it into a component. And I'm going to do the same thing for the rest of the icons. All right, so now I have all my icons here. One thing that we can do is we can put them into their own section just so that they're organized. From here, we'll make a component for our navigation item. To do that, I'm going to grab an instance of an icon, create a text layer. Can be something like item. We'll make the font size a little bit bigger and bolder. Now we're going to combine these two layers into auto layout. You can use Shift plus A keyboard shortcut to do it faster. We can set the space in between to 8. We can also give 8 vertical and horizontal padding. And let's rename this to navbar item. For our icon, we'll give the color of slate 400. And our text is going to be 900. We can also give this a border radius of 4. And we'll turn it into a component. And now we're just going to add one more variant for when this menu item is selected. And so when it's selected, the only change we want to make here is give it the background of slate 100. We'll also update property name to say active. And our first one is no, second one is yes. Now we're going to take an instance of our item and we're going to create all of these items here. So I'm going to have a dashboard, team. We can actually combine all these three items so far into auto layout. And we're going to set this to fill the container. So now when I resize it, all the layers inside resize together with it. We'll change this icon. Then we'll have projects, calendar, this one is folder, documents, and reports. We can call this overall frame menu. And there is this one more menu item that we have here at the bottom for like settings or your profile. And the only difference is that instead of an icon here, we're going to have an image like an avatar. So what we can do is we'll create a component for our avatar. It'll be pretty small. We'll give it the full border radius. And then for the fill, it's going to be an image. Let's rename it to avatar, turn it into a component. And now here I can swap this icon instance to an avatar instead. From here, what we're going to do, we're going to combine our name and the menu together in one auto layout frame. So as you can see here, I have the menu and another item for the profile settings. Actually, let's just move all of the stuff above so it doesn't get in the way. Another thing that we want to add here is our mini header where you have your logo and the collapse button. Let's do the collapse button first. What we can do is grab an instance of this chevron left icon. We'll actually make it a tiny bit smaller And we're going to wrap it inside its own add layout frame. And the width and the height will be 32. We'll center it. And we don't really need any padding or space in between. We can change the color of an icon to Slate 500. We'll also rename this layer to Icon Button. We'll want to add the border radius to it as well. Turn it into a component. And we'll add a second variant. So our second variant is going to have a fill of Slate 100. And the property name could be something like hovered. This first one is no. Second one is yes. And we can leave it like this for now. From here, we're going to take an instance of that component. We're also going to make a placeholder for our logo. It could really be anything that you like. So I'm just going to make something fun like this. Let's give the shape a fill. We can also rotate it a little bit and flatten, make it slightly bigger. Okay, so now we have our funky logo here. We're going to combine these two together, make sure they're centered. And we also want to have space in between set to auto so that every time this frame resizes, both the logo and the collapse button stay on the edges. And the last thing we're going to do is drop it inside our main frame, move it to the top, and set it to fill the container. So what we want to do with our layers now is we have a frame for our header, which we can rename to header, and rename the star to logo. Then we have our menu, and then we have our final menu item all the way at the bottom. Let's actually set it to fill the container. What we want to have here is we want to combine the menu and the header together because we want the space in between these two items always renamed the same, for example, 40. But then for this menu item below, we wanted to always keep it at the bottom, no matter how tall the overall frame is. So we'll set the space in between to auto. We can also keep the overall height at around 900 pixels for now. The next thing we're going to do is let's first just give it a fill of white so we can see better what's going on here. And we're going to give it horizontal padding of 24 and then vertical padding of 16. We can also round the corners. Let's do 4. We can also give it a very subtle stroke, just 1 pixel of Slate 100. The last thing we can do is make it slightly wider by default. And we want to make sure that everything inside is set to fill the container. Now we can rename this to navbar, turn it into a component, and now we're going to create another variant for it for the collapse state. So you can just add another variant, and you see it popped up here at the bottom. I'm going to add auto layout to the overall component set and switch the direction to horizontal so that we can see better what's going on here. And so for the collapse state, we don't really need anything here except the button. So we can actually safely delete everything that we have here. Of course, at this point, we want everything to be aligned to the top. We don't want to have any space in between because since we only have this one layer here, it will force it to be in the center. And so since we don't need anything except our icon button, I'm going to bring it out and then we can delete our header. All the nested frames. We're also going to set the overall width for the navbar to hug contents. Let's also decrease the horizontal spacing to 16. And the last thing that we want to do is change the icon from chevron left to chevron right. Let's update the property. We'll do like open. Yes. And no. Now we can start putting everything together into a small prototype that I showed at the beginning of this video. What we're going to do is let's grab an instance of our navigation bar. And I'm going to make a placeholder for our site content. We'll just drop it in auto layout. Also give it a fill of white. nice border radius and a stroke. Call it content. Let's make it bigger. Something like this for now. And now we're going to combine our content and the navbar together in one auto layout frame. We'll set the spacing in between to 16. And now, so this frame 3 here, it's going to be our main frame. We can call it like desktop view. And now we just want to make sure that we set the appropriate dimensions. So for the widths, we can do 1440. And for the height, we'll do fixed of 1024. Let's give this a background color of slate 500. And now we're going to add some padding around the edges. We'll do 16 horizontal and 16 vertical. Last thing, we also want to make sure that the height of our content and the navbar fill the container. And then we'll keep the navigation bar fixed at 260 pixels width. But then for our content, we want to make sure that it fills the container. And now what we can do is preview what we currently have. So usually when you just launch your prototype, sometimes it ends up looking too big. Personally, I like to set it to fit to screen. And you can do it either by going to the options here and setting it fit to screen, or you can just press Z on your keyboard until you get whichever option you want. So we have our screen here, but nothing is clickable yet. We'll return to our navbar component, and we're going to add a couple interactions here. So when you click on this icon, it's going to change to collapse state. Let's change it to smart animate so that the animation looks a little bit better without too much effort. And let's go back and check. So you see now I can click and collapse it. Unfortunately, I can't open it back up. So let's add another interaction going back. And now I can go back and forth. And as you can see, my content nicely resizes with the screen. And the reason that's happening is because the width of our content is set to fill the container, so that if the width of the navbar changes, then the content is going to take whichever space becomes available. One last enhancement that we can add is, so right now the collapse button is pretty subtle. Something that could be nice to add to it is an actual hover interaction. We've already created a variant for it. So what we can do now is just make sure that we add our interaction. And for this one, you want to make sure is that you set it to while hovering. Maybe we'll do simple dissolve and make it slightly faster. So now when you hover over it, you get the background color. And so that's it. One thing that we can do here is clean up our file. We'll make a section, call it components. And you can drop all of your components there so that they're organized. And that's it. Please let me know if you have any questions. I'll link this Figma file in the description. And until next time, bye-bye.